Now, by contrast, our cameraman is out with one of the greatest ships of the Royal Navy, HMS Duke of York. The past few months have taken heavy toll of our capital ships. The loss of the Prince of Wales and the Repulse, and the escape of the Scharnhorst and Gneisenau indicate that capital ships must always have fighter protection to preserve their great firepower for great occasions. The Duke of York has nuke-type 14-inch guns, the most powerful guns in the world. And now the camera takes us right into the front line with a convoy of troop ships. They're in dangerous waters, and it's good to see that there's an aircraft carrier forming part of the escort. Protection, and also part of the eyes of the fleet, which must never fail in its lookout. Through 2,000 miles, the convoy of troops plows on. Every mile is dangerous, so even when there's no enemy to shoot at, they keep in trim with target practice. More miles have been safely left behind. This convoy is well on the way to reinforcing our troops in operations overseas. Now planes begin to return from U-boat patrol to land on the aircraft carrier. It looks easy, but that's a dangerous job, even in peacetime. ...1942 sees the continuation of the ocean struggle that has raged without pause since September 1939. However well or ill may go the battle on other fronts, this is the front that we must hold to the end. The Navy is sorely strained and tested, but an island race can only be as strong as the strength of her ships and sailors. We owe every day of life to the Royal Navy.